Well, that's good to hear.
And I certainly support what you're doing.
Well, listen, I sure hope you get in there and get it.
I met with Secretary Rotman, who was up there a while back. And, you know, you won't have any problems developing energy and minerals in Alaska if I'm governor. And I know you want to do it. And I want to do it.
Great. So, go get him.
The gas line, of course, we're interested in getting that gas moving. It sure isn't right now.
No, I know. And I think that's a large part of that's the economy, isn't it?
Yeah. It's a question, I think, of too much government regulation. I think if government got out, the people who own the gas would get it out.
Mr. President, you have Senator Goldwater waiting for you.
Oh,
thank you.
Right.
Well, thank you very much.
You bet.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
See, we've got a group. You know everybody here.
Oh, sure. Hello, Senator.
Good to see you. Bill Clark. Hi, Bill. How are you
this morning?
Well, where do you want me to send you?
I'm right up there.
Jesus.
I don't say that with any ambiguity or equivocation.
No way. Well, and I appreciate your letter, and you know I feel the same way. And I know what your concern is. Share it and feel that we got to do some buttoning up before, as you say, we're gone, so that the things will remain the way they are. But while we're just sitting here, would you like to take a glance? This was when George Bush went to be king. This was my verbal message that was delivered to Chiang Ching-kuo in Taiwan at the same time.
People who pick out all the black and Mac Baldry.
Secretary of the Air Force, Russ Hale, who came up with the idea of bringing together the 12 chief executives who are the largest suppliers to the Air Force. Without impinging on your time, may I say that companies sometimes conduct buyer surveys in which they go out and say, what do you see in the products you'd like to buy in the future? We're doing a little of the reverse. We're their customer. We have brought them in to describe both this morning and this afternoon what we see as an Air Force for the next years in the future, so that there'll be a greater appreciation on their part of what we need, and in turn that will redound to our benefit as they gear up their industrial base and understand both our problems and our needs. And with that, we don't want to take any more of your time. We'll be delighted.
Well, I'll try to take only a moment or two here. I know that you are aware that I have a very firm commitment to rebuilding this nation's defense posture. And I've adhered to that commitment in the face of some severe budgetary pressures and difficult economic conditions. We've increased real defense spending in the last 2 years by 8.1% over the Carter budget, and that's in real dollars. And Secretary Weinberger's five-year defense plan calls for a sustained growth of 7%. Now, to succeed in this effort, however, to broaden the national political support for a strong defense posture, we need your help, as you can well understand, all the way. Bring weapon systems in the lowest cost possible without sacrificing quality. And we need help from all of you to find ways to not only exploit the newest technologies in our defense system, but if possible also to exploit those as economically as possible. Secretary Weinberger and Secretary Orr and their staff will be speaking with you during the course of this symposium about their initiatives to improve management and do all these things themselves. And while I'm speaking of the new technology, there's another thing. Maybe we should rerun that film that we made in World War II about being careful of how we speak, because I'm concerned, and I know you must be, about the tremendous outflow of Western technology of all sorts to the Soviet Union. And that is a threat to our security, because we'll always operate from a position of some numerical inferiority, and therefore retaining a significant lead in technology represents our chance and advantage over the Soviet Union. So we need help from all of you in regaining control over these technology losses. And for that, I'm going to shut up now. And I know I don't have long, the Junior Chamber of Commerce is already lined up.
Those guys. Mr. President, we alerted them that we might have 5 or 10 minutes of your time in the last question. But first, because I've served with you a long time, I understand you've got a new story about the bombing that occurred at Oxnard and Ventura and calling on an artillery. Are you the one that tell that story? Tell us the story about the artillery from San Jose.
It's a true story. World War II. You remember when a submarine launched and lobbed some shells onto the beach near Santa Barbara. It was between Santa Barbara and Goleta. Actually, there's a very intriguing story about that they found out, too, later, that the commander of that submarine had been the commander of a freighter in peacetime. He was a reserve officer. And there's a monument there to the first oil well on the beach, surrounded by a fence and with some cactus nests. There, while he was a captain prior to the war, he'd gotten up on the fence to try and get some snapshots of that and fell into the cactus. And the rest of the tourists that were around there got quite a laugh out of his pain and discomfort. And those shells, that's evidently where they were directed. No military targets. But the Corps Area Commander, when that happened, and thinking it might be the forerunner of a commando raid or something, found that the nearest field artillery was at San Jose, California, and got on the horn and ordered them immediately to the Santa Barbara area. Well, 24 hours later, they still hadn't showed up, and he got on the horn again pretty upset and wanted to know where the hell was the field artillery. And they gave their position approximately 20 to 25 miles south of San Jose. And he wanted to know what was going on, and they said, "Well, General, this is the, I can't remember the exact number, but the such and such horse-drawn field." They were proceeding on schedule.
Okay, with that, gentlemen, please.